Hey, what's going on guys? My name is Alex and welcome back to another video. Today I'm going to show you how to overclock your locked CPU in BIOS. And before I start, make sure you enable subtitles on my videos to understand better what I say. So yeah, let's start. This video was suggested by a fan and his name was PC Artist. I'm gonna leave the comment right now. And basically, he wanted me to make a video on how to overclock your locked CPU. Of course, this video is not only for him, it's for everyone that has a locked CPU, including me as well. So let's get straight to the point of this video. This video may be a little bit long, it may be around 7 to 8 minutes, I'm not sure. I'm not going to show you any advanced overclock, I'm gonna show you a simple overclock that I'm pretty sure everyone can do. And yeah, to head to your BIOS, boot up or restart your computer if you haven't already. And once the computer boots up, down here in the bottom, you should see something that says F2, F8, F12 or the delete, and next to the F key numbers it will tell you which key goes to where. The default keys that go to BIOS are, I'm pretty sure, F2, F12 and delete. For me the default key is delete. And yeah, once you find the key to go to BIOS, of course the interface will not be the same as mine, because if you have a newer motherboard, you will have a much better interface with way more settings. And yeah, if you have the same BIOS as me, the exact one right here, then you're in luck, because you won't have to find the settings manually. If you have a newer BIOS or a way older than I have, then unfortunately you have to find the settings yourself. So to overclock your CPU, you need to head to the first option, which says MB Intelligent Tweaker or MIT. And also, sorry for the shaky video, because I'm recording one-handed and I'm trying my best, so bear with. And one thing to do right now, you need to head to the second option, which says Advanced Frequency Settings, and you should see a window right here with the overclock settings. The one that you need to look for is down here where it says Base Clock BCLK Control. The default one will be, of course, disabled. Hit enter and change it to enabled. And the bottom setting, which says BCLK frequency megahertz, is 140. Right now, the default frequency, as it says right here, CPU frequency 2.8 gigahertz, and the same is set down here. If you hit enter, the lowest number that you can put is 100 and the maximum is 1200. Of course, if you put 1200, it's going to be 24 gigahertz, which is completely crazy, but do not even try it, because it will probably won't even boot up. Because 24 gigahertz, it's crazy and no CPU has hit that number yet, and it won't even hit it in the next couple of years. Of course, the number that I have here won't be the same as yours, it will be lower or higher, I'm not sure. And basically what you need to do, this is really simple, hit on top of the setting BCLK frequency and change it to the number that you want. Do not put any crazy numbers, because first of all, if you didn't know, if you overclock your CPU, the temperatures will increase. Depending on how much you overclock your CPU, the temperature will go around 10 degrees higher or so. But if you have a low-end cooler, the temps will be a lot higher. But if you have a high-end cooler that costs around 50 to 60 euros or even more, the temperatures may not even increase. It may increase around 2 to 5 degrees, but that's not a lot. The number that I put to overclock my CPU is 148, around somewhere here, and it takes me to 3 gigahertz. I have a low-end CPU, so I cannot overclock it to 3.2 gigahertz or 3.4 or even more, because I have a low-end cooler. And as you saw, when I changed the number, the CPU frequency right here changed from 2.8 to 2.96 GHz. And yeah, that's basically it. One thing to do as well, if you go to the setting right here, which says Advanced CPU Core Frequencies, and you hit enter, you need the settings all to auto or enabled, exactly as I have them right here. But of course, you can change the ones that you want to disabled or enable or whatever you want. I have it on auto because I do not want to mess around with the BIOS settings. And last thing to notice, that when you overclock your CPU, your RAM, which is right here, memory frequency, it's the RAM in other words, has overclocked as well. The speed of my RAM is 1333 megahertz and it has gone to 1480 megahertz. And of course, if I change it back to the default number, which was 140, the RAM frequency has changed back to 1400. So yeah, in other words, you overclock your CPU, but you also overclock your RAM as well, which is not bad. It will make your system responsiveness quite a bit faster than before. And also be careful what settings you change right here. Make sure that you are in the correct settings that I have. Make sure you change the BCLK frequency that I have right here. And yeah, lastly, you can change the voltages as well. If you go to the advanced voltage settings and you hit enter, here you can change the voltages right here. And here, do not change the voltages unless you know what to do. I recommend you letting it to auto, so your BIOS changes the voltages automatically. And yeah, that's everything it. And last lastly, what you need to do, go to the main menu, which is right here, hit save and exit setup, and here will pop up another window. Just hit Y for yes and hit enter to restart your computer. And yeah, that's everything good. Sorry for the not best overclock video, because I'm only 17 years old, I still have a lot to learn, and I don't know all of the BIOS settings, and English is not my mother tongue, as you can see on the description, of course. And yeah, so I try my best, and I apologize again for not the best overclock video. As I said in the start of the video, if my video did not help you, you can of course go to Google and find a guide on how to overclock your CPU. And yeah, that's everything good. That's the video, guys. Thanks for watching. If you have any problems, tell me in the comment section, that try to help you as much as possible. If you have any video ideas, tell me in the comment section, that try to make them in the future. Thanks for watching, guys. Like, subscribe and share, and I'll see you in my next video. See ya!